Faith the Podcast. We're so excited that you guys are joining us, and hopefully you'll join us all the time now. Meet Chris. Chris is the co-author to the book, Men of Faith, that we wrote. Well, I thought of, Chris wrote. How are you, Chris?
I am doing well, you know. Every day, like they always say, every day above ground is a good day, right?
That's it. That is it right there. I'm super excited, Chris, that I get to do this with you. Just like we work together for the book. And my prayer for all this is that we reach lots of people. We're able to encourage people and kind of speak about, you know, mental health and all of those topics where especially Christians feel like they can't talk about because people look at them like they're faithless or, you know, look, we live in this crazy world and we all have our struggles. I do believe that a person that says they don't struggle, I don't even know what planet they're from. But to me, it's not a thing, right? Even the Bible tells us we will struggle. And we see that right now with this crazy virus going on. But I don't even want to talk about this virus today. So tell us a little bit about you, Chris.
All right. So let's see. What do you want to know? I write professionally. It's what I do all day, every day. I've been a writer, full-time writer, for I guess the last 8 straight years, off and on over the course of the last 20 years. And I switched careers a couple of times, both switching from writing to graphic design and marketing and then back to writing, which is what I really love. My degree is actually in graphic design and illustration. And I did work in that sector for a while, but just writing has always been something I've done since I was a little kid, even writing. I look at writing almost as a teaching platform. And that's something that I've done since I was a kid too. I grew up like, you know, whenever we'd have snow days or whatever, I would teach my siblings or my cousins at home and just try to keep them occupied and out of my mom's hair. And I just kind of had a natural gift towards teaching and writing and just kind of the creative life. So that's what I do. I live in Williamsburg with my wife and my 3 kids, and every day it's a new adventure.
Yes, it sure is. Every day is a new adventure. So let me tell you guys. So Chris definitely has been placed in my life by God. Like God just picked him up, said here, bam, help this lady out because she needs you. So that's kind of how I met Chris. I was looking for somebody to help me write the book because people think my English is good enough. Well, you haven't seen me write anything yet. Like you hear me speak and we're good to go, but the writing part, not so much. And God just kind of brought us together and it was a journey. It really was a journey and I'm excited to share some of this journey with you guys. And so, yeah, there was lots of prayer involved in the book and there was hard times and there was funny times but God definitely saw us through that. Like, I don't think I could have done it or Chris, you could have done it without the help of God. It was definitely some hard times, but we're reaching people and that was our goal. Reaching people with the book and a message of love and forgiveness most of all, because I had to learn what forgiveness meant. I never thought that I could forgive anything that happened to me in my past, right? I held on to that. And I thought if I forgive, that means that I will say, oh, it's okay. It's cool that you did that to me, but I will forgive you. No, that's not what it is at all. It's about, you know, for me, forgiveness gave me life back because, yeah, I was all in the wrong places. And it doesn't matter if that started as a teenager with drugs and alcohol and all that kind of stuff. But even as an adult, just struggling to every day, just lying. My whole life was a lie. And so I learned that forgiveness is more for me because God wants me to have a pure heart. God wants me to be able to love and to trust. And that will only be able, we will only be able to do that with forgiveness, because things will happen to us in this lifetime. And I believe that everybody I know has been through some stuff. So that's why we're here. We're just here to talk about some things and mental health, especially, because nobody likes to talk about that. We talk about addiction and all of those things that people just really don't want to bring up or talk about. And we want to encourage everybody to say, I will open up, because yes, I've been through a lot, but if I speak up, I can come out of this mess. As long as I just eat it up and eat it up, if I don't let go of that stuff, it's gonna determine my life. So I guess that's a good explanation why we're here. Chris, what do you think?
Yeah, faith has been quite a journey, you know, getting a chance to know you, know your life, and then be able to use this as a platform to talk to other people about their lives. I think it's an opportunity, like you said, for people to be open on a platform where they can be honest, where they can express themselves with, you know, there's no judgment. It's just really about helping other people who have gone through what they've gone through, to relate to them, to know that it's okay to talk about it. It's okay to express feelings about it. It's okay to be angry about it sometimes. Sometimes you have to be angry. You got to have a good cry about things sometimes. Sometimes you have to have a hard talk with somebody. But getting to that point of mending your faith, like you said, is about forgiveness. And forgiveness is really more about us than the other person. You know, it's about us reconciling with God, saying, okay, you know, I don't have to be the judge, the jury, and the executioner here. I put that upon God. You'll have to reconcile what you did to me. I can let you off the hook, because it's good for my heart. Because the longer, it's like keeping a bag of dirty trash in your house, like for weeks and months and years. Like, I mean, what do you think happens? You know, after a week, it starts to smell a little bit. After 2-3 weeks, it really starts to smell. Mm. You might get maggots in your house. It just becomes very disgusting. And so forgiveness is just the act of just taking that trash out every single time it fills, take it out, and removing it. Getting the idea that people owe me an apology. I have to get past that. I had to learn to get past that. You had to learn to get past that, because while people should apologize, do they always know? Because there's this pride, there's this barrier that if I apologize to you for something, then I'm admitting that I wronged you, and I don't want to admit that I wronged you. And so that's why we have to do it upon. That's why we have to take it upon ourselves. That Christ said, just, hey, I'll forgive and just move along. That's why he was able to do what he was able to do. If Christ had to wait for all of us to apologize before he could absolve all sin, he'd still be waiting right now, and we'd still be left in our darkness.
No telling where we would be without him, right?
Right.
There's just no telling. So I'm super excited what this podcast will hold, and we'll have guests. Mm-hmm. Every other week, we're going to have a guest, and I'm super excited. We talked to some really, really cool people already, and they agreed to be on the podcast. We have different authors and all that kind of stuff. So I'm super excited to just share all of our stories. And of course, I'm asking everybody that would like to be on the podcast, just go to the website, which is mendedfaith.com. There's a form that you can fill out, and we'll check it out, and then we'll contact you and see if you want to be on the podcast sharing your story and just your testimony to help others to just overcome things. So that will be awesome. And of course, we would love if you would subscribe to our Mended Faith YouTube channel. And I see everybody else, they always do this, like below. Right. You can always, of course, visit our Facebook page, Mended Faith. And yeah, that's pretty much all I have today for the introduction.
Yeah, and we're excited to have you. We're looking forward to you sharing your story. It's like the scriptures say in 2 Corinthians 1, you know, our story isn't our own. You know, we go through our hardships and our trials and our difficulties, not for our own sake, though they do help us, but for the benefit of other people. So we're just excited to hear from you and just see how your story changes somebody else's eternity. You can rewrite someone's entire existence by the things that you share. So we're excited that you'll be with us, you'll join us, and we're excited for the people who will listen, because you'll get the same benefit.
Yes, for sure. Oh, and before I forget, if you would like a copy of the book Mend the Faith, you can purchase it everywhere where there's books sold. And if you would like a signed copy, you can also purchase that on our website, mendthefaith.com, and we will sign it for you. So I hope that we see you all next week. I am so looking forward to it. You guys have a wonderful rest of your Wednesday, and hope to see you soon.
All right, bye guys.